وما أدراك ما الحاق.
الحمد لله، الحمد لله على حلمه بعد علمه، وعلى عفوه بعد قدرته، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا. أما بعد، respected viewers, welcome back once again to our program where we look at certain ayats and themes that will be recited in today's Taraweeh. Today we are looking at the 22nd juz of the Holy Quran, which coincides with the virtue of the wives of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Allah Ta'ala says, Ya Nisa al-Nabi, lastunnaka ahadim minan nisa. O wives of the Prophet, you are unlike other women. Your status, because of being in the household and being in the nikah of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is very great. Allah Ta'ala further says, إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيُذْهِبَ عَنْكُمُ الرِّجْسَ أَهْلَ الْبَيْتِ وَيُطَهِّرَكُمْ تَطْهِيرًا. Verily, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wishes to remove any types of impurity, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wishes to purify and elevate your status. The wives of the beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are indeed a role model for Muslim women throughout the world and throughout the centuries in history. And they had granted great amount of lessons, and they are part of the Ahl Bayt and part of the family of our beloved Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam. In the 35th verse of the surah, which is almost in the second rakat or the first rakat of today's Taraweeh, so beautifully Allah Ta'ala says, counting the good qualities of the male and female, innal muslimina wal muslimat, the Muslims, male and female, wal mu'minina wal mu'minat, the believing males and the believing females, wal qanitina wal qanitat, the devoted males and females, was sadiqina was sadiqat, subhanallah, those who give charity, male and female. Charity is not only the prerogative of males, it's also the females. Was sadiqina was sadiqat, والمتصدقين والمتصدقات, that is with regard to charity, and those who are truthful, male and female, والصائمين والصائمات, those who keep fast, male and female, والحافظين فروجهم والحافظات, those who protect their modesty, male and female, والذاكرين الله كثيرا والذاكرات, and the males and the females who remember Allah in abundance, أعد الله لهم مغفرة. For them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept forgiveness and a very great reward. Allah Ta'ala speaks about our beloved Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from the third ruku of this juz. And then it coincides with these beautiful verses. Ya ayyuhan Nabi, O Nabi, inna arsalnaka shahid. We have sent you as in someone who will give evidence on what the people are doing. Shahida wa mubashira wa nadhira, one who gives glad tidings, one who warns. وَدَاعِيًا إِلَى اللَّهِ بِإِذْنِهِ, who calls people towards Almighty Allah with the permission of Allah. وَسِرَاجًا مُنِيرًا, and a radiant light. And it continues speaking about various aspects of the greatness of our beloved Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and his rights. And then it culminates in the 56th juz of the chapter. إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُسَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِي. O people, verily Allah and his angel, they send yusalluna, they send salat and peace and salam upon the Nabi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, O you who believe, you also join Allah and the angels in sending salat and salam, selling salam and peace and salutations upon the greatest of Allah Ta'ala's creation. Obviously, Allah Ta'ala sending salat, the malaika sending salat, the human being sending salat, the believer sending salat, it will have different connotation. But it just shows the greatness of our beloved Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And in today's Tarawih, we will be reciting this verse, which emphasizes upon us to recite Darood upon our beloved Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in abundance. From the quarter of the juz, we start a surah known as Surah Sabah. Subhanallah, one of the great surahs, in the sense that it imparts a very great lesson. The tribe of Sabah were in the region of Yemen, and they were people whom Allah Ta'ala had blessed tremendously. Allah had granted them wealth. Allah had granted them children. لَقَدْ كَانَ لِسَبَئٍ فِي مَسْكَنِهِمْ آيَةٌ. Allah Ta'ala says, we had granted them so much wealth. Jannatani ayyamini wa shamal. Two lines of orchards on the right hand side, on the left hand side. So prosperous and so full of blessings of what Allah Ta'ala had granted them, that the historians narrate that no one had to even pick the fruit from the tree. You carry a basket, you go through the orchards, by the time you come to the end, what actually happens is your basket is full. You know, that's how Allah Ta'ala had granted them. But you see, when Allah Ta'ala grants us any ni'mat, any favors, with that comes a responsibility to be grateful. They didn't fulfill the responsibility that came with the privilege. And Allah Ta'ala then makes mention, you know, they had so much favors, but yet after those favors, they did not show gratefulness to Allah. And Allah Ta'ala took away those favors and Allah Ta'ala punished them. A very great lesson for us, if Allah gives us something, never ever make na-shukri. Never be ungrateful. Allah has granted us so much. There's one beautiful incident, very briefly I will make mention. A 70-year-old person went for an operation because he could not pass water. Right? After the operation, he started crying when he saw the bill. And many a times when you see the bill, you will start crying. However, when he started crying, the doctor was compassionate and said, don't worry, you pay me whenever you are able. I'm not, you know, going to enforce or emphasize that you give me immediately. So he said, doctor, I'm not crying because I can't pay. Allah has given me money. But I'm crying that for 70 years I used to go up and down to go and relieve myself. Allah never sent me a bill. One day I couldn't do so. You had to do an operation, you send me a bill. You know, Surah Safatir speaks about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's many of his favors. Ya ayyuhan nas, antumul fuqara'u ila Allah. O people, you are poverty stricken in front of Allah. Allah ta'ala antum wallahu wal ghani. Allah is independent, full of praise. Iyasha yudhibkum. He is so independent. If he wants, he will destroy you. Wa ya'ti bi khalqin jadid, and he will bring another nation. وَمَا ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ بِعَزِيزٍ. It's not difficult for Almighty Allah. Allah Ta'ala makes mention of this. أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ أَنزَلَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً. Don't you see the rain that comes out, which brings greenness to the vegetation? فَأَخْرَجْنَا بِهِ ثَمَرَاتٍ مُخْتَلِفًا أَلْوَانُهَا. And that vegetation has different and most beautiful colors. وَمِنَ الْجِبَالِ جُدَدٌ بِيضٌ وَحُمُرٌ. Subhanallah, even amongst mountains, sometimes mountains you see that they are very dark, and then they are very, very light. And some of them are red. وَمِنَ الْجِبَالِ جُدَدٌ بِيضٌ وَحُمُرٌ مُخْتَلِفٌ أَلْوَانُهَا. And they are different colors. Subhanallah, it shows the greatness of Allah Ta'ala's creation. One last ayat I will make mention before we conclude today's program. Allah Ta'ala says, إِنَّمَا يَخْشَى اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءِ. That the learned are those who fear Allah. You will not get a better definition of ilm and knowledge than what Allah has given. The real learned people are not those who have degrees. The real learned are those who fear the Creator, who fear the one who has granted them all favors. May Allah Ta'ala make us amongst those who are learned in the true sense. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
Al-haqqatu mal-haqqah. وَمَا